right thing. But she seemed all evil at the end.
Not evil. You killed her son, lad. Her son. The death of a child is not something a parent gets over easily.
But he was gonna kill her.
She would have died to see him live. Only a parent can understand.
So you'd let me kill you?
If it meant you would live. Yes.
Look, there was no easy choice. For anybody, brother. But I think we can all agree you did the right thing. The world's a better place with Freya in it. Just give her time, lads. She'll come around.
Back to Tyr's temple, then. One last time.
Aye. Jotunheim awaits.
Why did Baldur say we cost
him? Odin must have convinced him that following you to Jotunheim would bring his cure. Lies, I'm sure.
Why did Mistletoe break the spell?
Vanir magic is powerful, but its rules are slippery and elusive. I'm sure it makes sense if you're a witch. Oh, but it's also bloody tragic. Baldur was the greatest gift Odin granted Freya. The one thing she treasured from their marriage. She only hoped to spare him pain and spare herself loss. But such impulses can lead good parents to make terribly stupid decisions.
I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. For instance, Odin hates the giants, and they him. But Thor's own mother was the giantess Björgun, one of Odin's great loves.
So Thor's half-god and half-giant? Weird.
Once Björgun was gone, lonely ages passed for Odin. And as war with the Vanir raged, I could see what he really wanted beneath his bluster. And after no small amount of convincing, Freya agreed. For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy.
You know what?
I'll tell this one later.
Something.
Let me guess.
Here we go. I can't believe we're going to see the giants.
Well, if things work according to plan. Go ahead and lock in Jotunheim and we'll be on our way. Probably.
Hope this doesn't cause you to explode or anything.
Oh, I hadn't considered that. Maybe we should talk about this a bit more.
Nah, I'm sure you'll be fine. Ready?
Whoa! That's unpleasant!
Now, boy! We must be close.
Well, what are we waiting for? Think it's far?
We will see.
A word, please, before we continue. Listen, the last thing you two need up there is a decomposing heat ruin in the moment. Why don't I wait for you here? This is between you and the boy.
True. But if someone were to fight...
My Lady Sif's soft, perfect sloshers. You done did it.
Sorry. We had to see this.
Oh, no. No, 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 no. Fine, damn it. Fine.
Watch the head till we return.
I can do this. No, no, I can't. Oh.
Okay.
Ready. Come.
Look! We're on the giant's fingers. I can see the highest peak ahead. Right over there. We did it.
We did.
What are you doing?
I have nothing more to hide.
Can we go now? We're so close.
Boy. Boy.
It's nothing. I just thought I'd hear voices by now. Hello? Anybody here?
What is this place?
They must have all come through here when they left Midgard. What was left of them. Odin and Thor, ruining everything for everybody. The giants came back home so they could survive. But I'm not sure they did. Huh. Who's the guardian? I should feel them, but I don't. This place is dead. What happened to that? Why'd Mom send us here?
One question is answered, and two more take its place.
Wait! Father! Something's happening! Your axe. It's Mahler. Look. She's arguing with a bunch of giants. She knew giants? That's us. The first time we met the world serpent. But how? And our fight with Baldur. But that just happened. Wait. They knew everything that was going to happen. The dragon in the mountain. The stone mason. All these drawings. This is our story.
No. This is your story.
But what does it all mean?
That I was not the only parent with secrets.
You didn't know. She was a giant. I'm a giant. Why didn't she tell us?
She sent us here knowing we would find this.
But why not just tell us the truth?
Your mother would have had good reasons. Baldur was never sent to find me. He was tracking her all along, not knowing she was only ashes.
If she had a plan for us, I trust it. Whatever it is. Besides, she hasn't been wrong yet. Come on. We're so close to the end now.
Yes. Yes, we are.
Look, it's Mother's. She was here. She saw every step we took before we took it. Like she was always with us. Watching over us. Leading us home. Let's finish it.
No. We do it together. Son. Goodbye, Faye.
I love you, Mom. The Giants. They really are all gone. There's nothing for us here.
Come.
So, I get that mother was a giant. Which makes me part giant and part god.
And part mortal.
Right. I guess there's just one thing I don't understand. My name on the wall. The giants called me Loki?
Loki? When's the name your mother wanted for you when you were born? She must have called you that to her people.
But why?
A question for another day. Let us go home.
Did she know it was gonna be like this here? Is this what she wanted us to see? Did she want us to tell the people or keep it a secret?
I do not know.
So what should we do?
I trust you to decide that.
Oh. Oh, so why'd you want to name me Atreus? I know it can't be for a god.
No. He was a soldier. A Spartan.
The great warrior?
All Spartans are great warriors. We trained from birth. Our lives were discipline, duty, battle, and death. Life was grim, and we greeted it grimly. But Atreus of Sparta was unlike the rest of us. He wore a smile even in the worst of times. He was happy. He inspired us to hope. That though we were machines of war, yet there was humanity in us. Goodness. When the day came for him to lay down his life in battle, his sacrifice saved countless others and turned the tide in our favor. I carried him home on his shield and buried him with all the honors of Spartan custom. His memory was a comfort in dark times.
Wow! You actually told a good story. I mean, you missed it! If you want to go home, but maybe helping people was part of why Mom sent us out here, too. I mean, what would Atreus of Sparta do?
And what would Loki do?
Huh. That's a weird name. I'm glad we went with yours.
Glad to see you. I believe I've reached my limit for dwarven charm.
What happened, Mimir?
They took an uncomfortable number of measurements and then proceeded to bicker about the weather.
Where do you want us to take you?
How about the warm confines of anywhere bloody else?
Atreus, follow me.
Sorry, I got distracted. The serpent tell you when you spoke? Kinda sounded important.
I'm sure it's nothing. He just said the boy seemed familiar to him.
Me? That's impossible.
Though I quite agree. Unless, perhaps, he refers to something yet to be. It is said that when Jormungandr and Thor battle at Ragnarok, their clash so violently shakes the Tree of Life that it splinters, casting the serpent backward through time, even before his own birth.
What?
That is madness.
Well, I did say not to concern yourself.
Wow. Take a look at this thing.
Freezing!
Huh?
Oh, every time. What you got?
Now what was it? the other thing.
So what was it like when Odin and Freya got married?
Granted her so many wishes, I can scarcely recall them all. The peace held, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned. But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. He won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would live to bitterly regret. And we'll pick this up later.
Here. Boy.
Sir. Hey, it's another treasure map.
Thank you. these bones pulse with magic.
It must be Govi. Could we... Can you just hold on to it? Maybe we'll find the rest of it.
My spirit lies to you, boy.
How would you know?
I have known many spirits. They are all liars.
This one is different. I know it.
You know very little.
I always wondered what became of him.
Wait, Fafnir? Like, Fafnir Thorong Fafnir?
The very one.
But Sindri said he was a dwarf.
He was, and now he's a dragon. Funny how life works, isn't it?
He's chained up.
Perhaps we should keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Aye, lads?
Dragon, Amir.
Oh, he's no friend of mine. This little scroat was a constant source of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why free him?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. Greedy little dwarf come dragon.
You've never answered the boy's question there. How did this dwarf become a dragon?
I don't know for certain, though I wager his penchant for stealing magical artifacts had something to do with it. He must have stolen a trinket from the wrong Vanir goddess.
Yeah.
time to set him free. Think he'll remember you?
I don't know, lad. A lot's changed since we last crossed paths. I had legs.
You wee little bugger.
Well, the dragon hasn't done much for his personality.
Roy, over here.
Hold on. Let me read.
Thank you. spirit to keep its word is foolish, boy.
But if there's even a chance, don't you want to see Mom again?
Of course I... She is gone, Atreus. You must accept this.
I do, but to see her again. Just one more time.
Why do you believe him? You do not know him or who he was. All of this is sinister.
He wants to see someone he loved again. I understand how that feels. I don't think there's anything sinister about it.
Hope is blinding your instincts, boy.
So Odin and Freya could have been happy. But he only wanted her magic?
Aye. Sadly, despite his wise counselor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was the only true path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. The taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity.
So desperate to find a way into Jotunheim anyway.
He's convinced the giants hold the key to changing his fate when Ragnarok comes. They are the Aesir's oldest enemies, after all. And it's their army that's supposed to do him in the end. But more than that, he covets their gifts of prophecy. He wants to know what they know and see what they see. So much suffering could have been avoided if his insatiable curiosity was not so much stronger than his wisdom.
What do you mean?
Ah, remind me to tell you why they call him the Lord of the Hang.
Is it a good idea coming back here?
She's probably in there planning your demise, brother.
Or bringing Baldur back to life. Like she did you, Mimir.
Oh, I'm not alive, lad. I'm reanimated, sure. But make no mistake. I'm still quite dead. I'll never be what I once was. She won't want this for her son. Trust me.
That's a relief. Not the part about you being dead, but... you know. Another one of those sand bowls.
What does it say?
Falcon, hawk, and turtle dove. Swim aloft in oceans above.
Those runes on the rock.
They don't spell anything. It's gibberish. Want me to read this one?
Atreus, follow me.
Sorry.
Here, boy.
I know those runes. That's Vinder. Wind. Must be for that sand bowl down there.
Draw it.
Sir. Vinder. Look what it did!
Here, boy.
Okay, that's going in the journal. we go from here. Doesn't seem to be.
Boy.
Hey, I think I see another one of those bowls of sand up there. That I drew the rings into? Not sure how we reach it. Father! There. I see something up there. Thank you. symbols. There are different runes written along the side of this one.
Boy.
Yes, sir. Bow. Bet I could reach that with some help.
another Valkyrie.
What's happening?
Ready yourself.
No. Focus up, boy.
That refers to a modest example of Odin's thirst for knowledge. The time he spent 9 days a dead man. Aye, hung himself by the neck from Yggdrasil's branches, put his spear through his own side and bled down into the Well of Destiny. He roamed the realms of the dead and plundered the World Tree of its secrets, until I think quite rightly it got fed up with him and sent him back to the land of the living. Did I not mention he was barking mad? felt that one.
Watch out!